Our donor had a vision. She recognized that we weren't doing enough, frankly, to address some of the serious environmental challenges that we face. And we needed to do more.
So the origin, really, of the decision to build a living building in Atlanta was Diana took a tour of the living building, the Bullitt Center in Seattle, was completely blown away. I think the Kendeda Building is a really good tangible example of action on climate change. We're talking about large scale change and thinking about things incredibly differently than the way they've already been done.
I think creating the next at Georgia Tech is all about starting something new, pioneering something that no one has ever done before, and making a difference in some positive way. I think this building really exemplifies that.
When we think about a space like the Living Building, we're recognizing that, you know, this is an aspiration of how things could be, that it's technologically possible to run a system that operates with very low energy draw and still provide a beautiful, compelling space that's comfortable and healthy.
In the construction industry in general, we actually don't have like an FDA. So we just don't have this history of being required to disclose all the chemicals within the components that make up our buildings. So that's one of the wonderful things about this Living Building Challenge is it requires that.
Getting through the red list compliance, that was truly a challenge, and that probably took a lot more time than anybody expected. But we've moved the needle in the market, I think, and that's one of the things that will make it easier for the next Living Building Challenge project.
On the solar panels, they are tackling so many imperatives. It's amazing. Not only are they generating electricity, they also are a water collection device. And our primary heating and cooling is sending chilled water or hot water through our floors. We have 62 ceiling fans throughout the building, and that is really our localized temperature control.
The pedal that I'm working on is the equity pedal, and so that focuses on making sure everyone has same access to the building, everyone has a positive experience within the building, regardless of who you are, what you look like, your socioeconomic status.
Equity was a challenge, right? It's harder to measure. Yeah, some things definitely make sense. You want to make sure that the building is more than just ADA compliant. You know, my dad was disabled. One of the first things I noticed about the renderings of this building is that the ramp is in the center of the building. To me, growing up, always trying to find the ramp, it was in the back, it was tucked away, it was difficult to get to. I noticed that right away. I knew why it was done, and it was special to me.
We're gonna have hundreds of people going in and out of this building every day during class periods. So it's not just the classes that are oriented towards sustainable design, but calculus or, you know, math classes, things like that. It'll just be an opportunity for us as a campus to have as many students from diverse backgrounds occupy this building and see how it works.
We partner with a local nonprofit called Georgia Works. Georgia Works focuses on helping individuals who are at risk of chronic homelessness. It helps those individuals gain marketable skills. So 6 individuals in that program helped construct the ceiling that's in this building.
Our partner, Georgia Tech, says they're interested in creating the next, and that's exactly our goal with the Kendeda Building.
We have everything we need. to make some bold moves and to say, look, you know, this is something we can solve. When you think about the capacity that we have here at Georgia Tech amongst all of the computer scientists and engineers and you know, atmospheric scientists and you know, digital media experts, we can come together to really make a difference. And that's why I think this building is here, and that is definitely why I am here.
I have two daughters that are both under the age of 10, and when I think about what I hope this building will instill in them and a generation of young people like them, is to strive and to push the envelope and to not accept the status quo of how things have always been done in lots of domains, certainly in the green building and sustainability sphere, that's incredibly important, but in so many areas of the world. How do we create bold new solutions? How do we not accept the status quo? How do we push beyond what we thought was possible?